working on my chair that was my great grandpa's, and I've stained all of the wood. I stripped it, sanded it, and stained it with this traditional cherry, varathane traditional cherry, which you've been using that for. I got this little can a couple years ago, and I've been using it for everything. I made a couple picture frames. I made grips for a single action Colt 22 pistol. And I liked it so much, I put it on this. As far as I can tell, this wood is probably cherry, and I'm getting ready to do varathane polyurethane on it. And I'm using this, it says odorless. It's Klean Strip Green Odorless Mineral Spirits. And I'm doing it down here in my basement, so I didn't want to use anything that's gonna be really stinky and get a lot of fumes in here. And so I don't know, I've not seen anybody use this. It says you can use it to thin paints just like anything, or let's see exactly what it says. Use where mineral spirits is recommended for surface preparation, which I did use it before I put the stain on. I wiped everything down with mineral spirits. Surface preparation, thinning, or cleanup. Thinning oil-based coatings, add gradually and stir thoroughly until desired consistency is obtained. Do not use with latex paint. So we're gonna see how it works. This is a piece of cherry. I had drawn out on it a knife handle. I used it. I didn't use that tracing. I used a different section of it. I've been using chunks of this tree for a couple years, probably as long as I had that stain. I think I've made a picture frame out of some of it. Gun grips, a knife handle. But if I want to use it for something else, I can always sand this finish off, because I'm going to mix up some finish and just test it on here to make sure it turns out how I want. So, that's not what I need. I'm gonna start with a 50-50 mix, and I'm filming on my iPhone, so I'm not really gonna show up close. I might show the board up close once I am done putting it on, and then I'll have to see it's what I like. But I haven't really seen anybody doing this, and it's more for discussion and letting you guys know what I think about it. So if you were thinking about using this combination of products, that you know kind of what to think of it. This, I'm shaking it. If you haven't heard, don't shake your polyurethane, and because you don't want to get bubbles in it, because it'll leave bubbles in the finish, little bubble marks in the finish. So here we go. I'm trying to make a 50-50 mix of this. I don't want to get anything in the polyurethane. Wipe it off a little bit. I don't want to get any dust particles in there, because I'm afraid it'll show in the finish. So I want to make sure this is clean. I also don't really want to pour polyurethane. So I'm just going to dip this in here. I'm doing a tablespoon poly, just a small batch to see. A tablespoon of varathane polyurethane. And then I'll just pour this. It in. It looks like milk. The whatever that is called. Klean Strip Green Mineral Spirits. It looks pretty milky. And that's why I'm just worried that I'm gonna have some kind of I don't want it to look hazy. I want to make sure it turns out completely clear. And I might have to do this in a couple videos, but I'll post it again later. Because I don't really like editing videos. So it just looks like cream colored, and I told my girlfriend I would not ruin her measuring spoon, so I better go rinse it off right now. So there's that. Wipe this up off the board. This piece of cherry is really nice looking. I found one of the reasons why I think this wood for the cherry is because it has a lot of the grains, and like you can see, like it has some dark grain. Like spotty looking parts, which I don't know. The original stain was very heavy on it, which I tried to go a lot lighter. I don't know if somebody thought that it didn't look very good and wanted to stain dark so that it would cover up those marks, but I like that. I think it looks natural. I like the natural look. But anyway, 50-50 mix. I've been doing some research, and that's what they say to use for like a wipe-on poly. You can buy wipe-on poly, but they said you can make it too. So for my first coat, I'm gonna do 50-50, and then I'm gonna go 60-40, 70-30, 80-20, 90-10. But I figured since the 50-50 is like a wipe-on poly, I could start by wiping it on with my first coat. The trouble with this piece of wood is it's a very rough cut. My dad cut it on his, I call it a hillbilly sawmill. He actually got rid of it, but we'll see what it looks like with at least the first coat. And I'm just gonna leave it like that. It looks pretty smooth. It's already pretty clear. I don't think I'm gonna have a problem with the hazy look to it, but I'll back after a little while and post another video with that, and as long as it looks okay, I'm gonna start wiping on the first coat for the rest of the chair.